Hello, this is Dr. Anzar Ahmad and you're watching my channel Dr. Anzar Ahmad, which belongs to the lectures on cellular or mobile communication and mobile ad hoc network. In the previous lecture, we were talking about GSM or cellular architecture. Cellular or GSM architecture is divided into four segments: mobile set MS, base station subsystem BSS, network switching subsystem NSS, and operation and maintenance subsystem ONMS. In today's video, we are going to explain every segment separately. First segment is known as mobile set. Mobile station or mobile set is made up of two entities: mobile equipments and subscriber identity module, which is known as SIM. Mobile equipments. Mobile equipment is a portable, vehicle-mounted, handheld device. It is used for voice and data transmission. It is uniquely identified by an IMEI number of 15 digits long. IMEI stands for International Mobile Equipment Identity Number. IMEI is mentioned at the time of manufacturing the handset by the manufacturer. The main functions of mobile equipment include radio transmission, monitor power and signal quality of surrounding cells for handover, speech encoding and decoding, error detection and correction, signaling and access to the SIM. Subscriber identity module stand for subscriber identity module. SIM is an integrated circuit that contains some very useful information related to a subscriber and network operator. SIM contains IMSI, stand for International Mobile Subscriber Identity Number, authentication key, and ciphering generation key. IMSI is used to authenticate the user in the network. After proper authentication only, a user is allowed to send and receive call and other subscribed services. How a user is authenticated in the network and how his or her communication is encrypted in the network, we will explain in separate video. Second segments of GSM architecture is known as base station subsystem, which has two identity: base station controller and base station transceiver. Base station controller is the most strong element in BSS. It communicates with MSC and BTS. It provides intelligence to the BTS. One BSC can support 20,000 to 45,000 subscribers at a time. One BSC can control 16 to 512 of BTS under itself. Various functions of BSC. BSC help out to set up the call, manages radio resources for BTS, assign frequencies and time slot for all mobile set in its cell. BSC also provide handover to mobile set. It also controls radio power. Base Transceiver Station BTS. BTS is the physical equipment which provide radio coverage to a geographical area which is known as cell. It communicates with MS and BSC. It consists of transceiver TRX units. One BTS can support 100 users simultaneously. It encodes, encrypts, multiplexes, modulates and feeds the RF signal to the antenna. It provides frequency hopping also. This is the diagram of typical GSM BTS. A GSM cell site consists a shelter and a tower. In the figure you can see this is a tower and this is a shelter. This is interesting to know what a shelter consists in itself. This is a figure which is showing the BTS shelter. BTS shelter consists ACs, BTS cabinet, MCBs, digital distribution frame, SMPS, battery bank and power interface unit. Types of BTS. There are two types of BTS in GSM, ultrawave BTS and flexi BTS. This is a ultrawave BTS. It can support maximum of 12 TRX card. One TRX card support maximum of 8 user. Capacity in terms of user can be increased using half rate, that is assign one time slot to user. Flexi BTS. Flexi BTS can support maximum of 12 TRX as compared to Ultra BTS. This is easier set construction with easier implementation, lower installation cost, reduced demand for power resulting in small power system. All connections are on front side, so it is easy to install every equipment. Network switching system we will discuss in the next video. So please keep on watching my channel Dr. Anzar Ahmad and subscriber it. Thank you very much.